Welcome. In this video, I want to talk about using compression utilities on the command line on Mac and potentially Linux too. So I've installed a couple different command line utilities on here. The Mac will come with things like gzip and bzip, and you can install other utilities. I use the Mac port system to do that. I'll put a link in the description to my Mac ports video that I did on installing that. So in my last video, we talked about tar. And that takes a group of files and puts them into one unit. So what I have here is this data.tar is this. I've combined everything in the data folder into this. So you can add a flag to your tar to compress it, but for sake of argument, let's say you can't do that and you want to zip this up. So a common utility people use is gzip. So we'll look at gzip. We'll type gzip space dash h. And we have the help file here. You can look at the compression levels here. And I often just use 9. Computers are pretty fast these days, so I want the smallest file. And then there's this C, or write to standard out. We'll talk about that. And the important thing to note here is that it says keep original files. So, and then there's other things. You can recurse into directories, things like that. So if we want to compress this, we can type gzip space dash 9 and then the data.tar, and this will compress this. Okay, if we look at our directory again, we have it compressed. But you'll notice it got rid of the data.tar, and that may be okay, or you may not want it that way. So to uncompress this, I'll type gzip space dash d for decompress, and then data. tar.gz. I'll run that and then we have it back. So let's assume we want to keep data.tar. So you have things in this file and someone wants a copy, you still want the tar unchanged. Or say it's some other, you know, like a big text document. So what we can do here is we can say gzip space dash 9 and then C, which will pass the output to standard out. And this will also keep the file intact. So we type data.tar, and if we ran this like this, this would create a bunch of illegible stuff on the screen. So we want to do a greater than symbol, which will send this to a file, and then we'll name the file data.tar.gz. And if we run this, what we end up with is this, the tar is there, and then the compressed file both. So there's different utilities work in different ways, so you want to look at the help file for the utility you want to use. So let's clear the screen here. Let's look at bzip. It's bzip2. And bzip2 also has this dash C option here. So it's the same thing. If you just bzip something, it will delete it after it's done. Otherwise, it will keep it there. And then if we look at xz, same thing here, this, you know, dash C. So in contrast, you have something like 7-zip, and 7-zip can do the same thing as tar and gzip together, but say you just want to use the compression in 7-zip. If we type 7z space A for add to the 7-zip archive, and then we'll type data.tar.7z, and then data.tar, okay, so this will compress it and it will keep the original there. So you see we still have the data.tar and then we have the second file here and it hasn't been changed. So those are the basics of compressing on the command line. There are many different things you can do with those, but I just wanted to get the basics. You can play around with them a bit. You know, you can probably like take a folder with a bunch of files in it and make a copy of it and play around with these a bit and learn. But if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. If you like this video, please click like. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, I would appreciate it if you could do that. And thanks for watching. Until next time, goodbye.